Wiggity wiggity, what is up, gamers? Today we're going to be taking a look at this absolutely beautiful Dell 660. Originally released in the early 2010s, this was a pretty common sort of lower-end home and office computer. But as you can see, we've gone ahead and made some modifications to it. Now originally this guy was powered by an i5-2320 processor, which is getting a little slow by today's standards, so we just went ahead and threw that one out. And we went ahead and replaced this with the blazing fast i5-3570. Next, I swapped out the original Dell power supply for this bargain bin Thermaltake 600 watt that I got for about 20 bucks, so not too bad of a deal on that. And last but definitely not least, we got the video card, which is a MSI NVIDIA 970 that I got for about $80. Now, the first issue I had with this card was that it was just too long for this case. The little cage here that holds the hard drive was actually blocking the end of the card from fully fitting into the case, so I said fuck it and took my metal clippers and just cut that right out. Now the next issue I had was the temperatures. It was getting about 60 degrees Celsius on idle, which is usually what you'd be seeing when you're playing a game, so that was a little worrying, I would say. Once we started up a game on it, it started causing a small nuclear reaction to happen inside the card, so I went ahead and pulled that out. I busted out the big toothbrush, scraped it down. There was a lot of dirt and kind of shit all over it. Scraped that off, or repasted it, slapped it back in there, and it was actually getting pretty good temperatures, so I'll call that a success. Now, the final problem with this card is a little strange. Every time I tried to play Shadow of Chernobyl on this thing, this would happen.
А ну, чики-брики в дамке!
Weird, huh? Well, you guys are probably wondering how this thing does in game, so let's take a look at some benchmarks.